And we're live. Hello everyone, welcome to another Slytherin Channel Twitch stream. And today we're playing Panzer Corps Sea Lion, and with me is Ian McNeil, Development Director of the Slytherin Group. Hello, Ian.
Hi guys, and yeah, as Bart says, we're going to be playing Sea Lion today, which has just released. It's the first Panzer Corps content. Oh, there we go. Notified of a live event. The first Panzer Corps content for, it's got to be a good 2, 3 years.
About that, yeah.
It's very exciting. I wasn't actually involved in the development of this expansion, so this is literally the first time I have played this, and it's going to be embarrassing, I would think. But let's see. You saw me having about 10 seconds of practice before we started. I do know that we are coming into Sea Lion and starting the invasion of Britain. The first scenario is about capturing the Channel Islands, so it should be a relatively simple operation. There's not a lot of British presence here. My briefing tells me that the most of the British aircraft, have, if not all, have left, and there's not a strong military presence. So it should not be too hard a scenario, which is good because I have not played Panzer Corps for quite some time. My bit of pop-up message here. I can't use any tanks. My tanks have all been allocated to this nice little resting area here. So one of the interesting things about this scenario is that these no entry zones have been used to split the game into three separate missions. So I have one mission up here for the smaller island, and I forget the name of the three islands for the Channel Islands, but that's a small one, maybe Sark or something. And then we've got Jersey and Guernsey. I can't remember which one's which, but two larger islands here. And these forces can't help each other, so each of the three forces has to complete their mission independently. And I don't get any tanks, so that makes life interesting. So I have three JU-52s, and because we've just finished the Battle of France, apparently all of my prestige has been removed. I've got no prestige to buy any new stuff, but I'm going to get some reinforcements at turn two, which will give me enough to repair, hopefully. So three JU-52s. I think that's paratroopers they're giving me here. Yeah, some paratroopers. Or do I have some attack strategic bombers as well? Right, so my force down here. No, it looks like my JU-52s are all paratroopers, so that'll be quite useful for grabbing some ground. So split into three sections. The section down here, what we got? We've got one, two, three, four, five transport ships with a variety of infantry and support units on board. Looks like an artillery, one artillery, one anti-tank, sorry, anti-aircraft gun and three infantry. One small attack boat and a reasonable amount of air power. We've got a few strategic bombers, a couple of fighters, and I'm not sure what that one is. That's a, oh, it's a 110. Now my aircraft are all out of range, so I'm gonna have to capture a an enemy air base to give me somewhere to refuel and rearm my fighters. So that hangar there looks like a prime location for capturing. So I think what we'll do is we'll deal with each one of these islands as a little separate mini mission. So I think we'll start with this one. So we've got a town here, something fortified up here. Our objectives are to capture this major objective here and here. But I think we'll probably start off with by sending in our paratroopers to try and grab this hangar so our aircraft got somewhere to return to. I'm going to use my boat to do a bit of scouting up here, see what we can find. Oh, enemy ships. A destroyer. Okay. It's only half strength, but it's still a lot more of a ship than my little Schnell boat. But we'll take them on. We have some air support as well. Strategic bombers are very good against naval targets, so I will bring in my JU-88. I'm pretty sure they're lethal against ships.
And they are.
There we go. That was relatively painless. So let's try and get some of our men ashore. That's pioneers. More pioneers. Grenadiers. That's our anti-aircraft gun. and that's our artillery. I think I'm going to try and land everyone somewhere down south where it's relatively safe. Bring our fighters in to do a little bit of scouting. Let me see. Tomatoes. A tomato truck. Well, there you go. See something new every day. Got some infantry. I think we will probably go and start hammering this hangar. Oh, we don't do anything to that. That's useless. Let's try something else. Our fighter, see if he does anything to the hangar. There we go. A little bit of damage. And we have our 110. Here, we're just going to have a look over this side, see what we can see. Ooh, what do we have here? A fort, Fort Hommet. Okay, that's a bit mean. These things have quite a decent range. So I think it's range 3. So 1, 2, 3. Yeah, we don't need to capture that, so we might just stay well away from that and keep on the east side of the island over here. But they don't have much air defense from what I remember, so we can probably bombs on them. Okay, so that.
Question here from the audience. What are the red dots you see when you select the
Right,
aircraft?
okay, I've just moved those ones, so I have to jump over here. The red dots mean that the aircraft is out of supply range to refuel. It's not in range of an air base to return to it because I've got no air bases on this map. And so I need to capture an air base, and once I do, the dots will disappear because they'll be in range. Well, assuming they have enough fuel to reach the air base anyway. So actually, I've got some paratroopers here. So the first thing we're going to do is land our paratroopers. They missed their target. They've dropped over here.
Okay. There's a random chance of that happening.
Yes, whenever paratroopers land, you're not quite sure where they're going to land. They can end up in a bit of a mess sometimes. And they also land in a suppressed state. So suppression is an important part of Panzer Corps. On the sidebar, you can see the strength points I have. I have 10 strength points, but 5 of them are suppressed. And those strength points can't participate in any attack. So these guys are actually, from an attack point of view, they're only at 5 strength points and quite vulnerable. So if anyone picks on them now, they're not at in their best state. So we have a bit of air support here. We've got some Stukas, which are very good at ground attack. Some fighters here, more fighters, more Messerschmitt 109s. And so we have no strategic bombers over this side, tactical fighters. We have some enemy cargo ships in port, and we have a destroyer here. So the first thing we'll do is get rid of this destroyer, because if this destroyer catches our troop transports, it's going to make mincemeat out of them. So we did take some damage on our Schnell boat, but it's worth it to get rid of this destroyer. Now, we're not sure what other naval power he's going to have up here. We're just going to scout out with our fighter, see what we can see.
Oh, well.
Oh, there's a coastal gun there, a powerful coastal gun. That's going to be pretty nasty if we land near that. We probably need to avoid that. We've got air defenses and artillery and infantry.
Well defended place.
This is pretty well defended, yeah. Because we're only coming at this with infantry, this is going to be a fairly tough nut to crack. But my fighter, he's going to get shot at probably by the anti-aircraft gun, but he's here. Excuse me. And so he might as well make the most of it and probably go at this cargo plane whilst, sorry, cargo ship. So he's done 5 damage to that. I'm going to leave my other Schnell boat on the flank here to guard against any enemy naval units coming in from this side. We're going to scout out this area a little bit with our fighter. Nothing. So this looks like a pretty safe place to land. We're going to focus our landings on this side of the island, because getting near that
Yeah.
is going to be painful. I didn't actually check what we have here. Oh, we have a scout car, a 232, artillery, infantry, Brückenpanzer, or bridging infantry, anti-aircraft gun, more infantry, grenadiers, kind of heavy infantry, and another artillery unit. So
It's quite a force, though, combined.
it's a reasonable force. If we can get them all ashore alive, it shouldn't be too bad. We are going to use our Stuka. I'm going to keep my Stuka with my fighter for protection at the moment. Stukas are very good, but they have very low air defense. So if an enemy fighter comes along, they will make mincemeat out of my Stukas, and I can't repair them because I've got no airfields. And so I need to keep him alive because he's going to be very useful, I think. So we're not going to risk him just yet. I think that's all my troops moved on the main island. And so we're over to the little skirmish at the top. Now here we have enemy artillery, infantry, and a hangar. So it doesn't look like there's an awful lot there. Let's come and hit his 25 pounders with some little bit of damage
Not
there.
bad.
He's going to scout out what's on the rest of this island.
Question here from the audience. What we're playing here, or this new content, what year does it take place in, and how does it fit in with the grand campaign?
Right, so the way Sea Lion works is it bolts into the Grand Campaign at 1940. So you can import your core force from the 1940 Grand Campaign. And the plan was that this would be when you win this, the war's over. That's the way that we had imagined it. But there's been a demand for people to go back into the Grand Campaign from this.
Right.
And so the designer, Nico, has actually already released a little update on the site. If you go to Slytherin and check the forum. He's releasing something to allow you to patch your force from this back into the 1943 campaign, so you can take your force back into the Grand Campaign. But I haven't actually tried that out yet because he's only just posted that on the site.
Okay. So, and those of you who don't know, Operation Sea Lion was a is a hypothetical campaign of the German invasion of the British Isles. So it's right after the conquest of France. They're launching an amphibious assault on England. I mean, it was planned, wasn't it?
They had plans for it. Whether it was actually they'd ever try and execute them or not was it's a big debate about that. Some people say it's not possible because of the Royal Navy, and others say that the Luftwaffe would have taken care of the Royal Navy. So there's various arguments about it. But that's everything for turn one. So we're going to see what the AI is up to. Oh, just found some enemy ships, anti-aircraft guns, more anti-aircraft guns, and that's it. So. That's our end of term report. The weather's clear, which is good for us because we have air superiority, and the weather can really reduce your effectiveness of your fighters and your bombers. And our objective, take all objectives and airfields. Oh, I didn't read that part. And airfields. Oh, that's for a major victory. To get a marginal victory, it's just capture the objectives.
And is it like in one of the in some of the previous Panzer Corps content where the campaign would branch into different missions depending on
Yes,
your
Sea Lion has an awful lot of branches. There's actually a mission tree up on the forum. I think I can't remember if it's on the product page, but definitely on the forum, which shows how the missions all branch. So there's three key branches through Sea Lion, and each of them has around 10 or so scenarios.
Wow.
So it's about 30 or so missions altogether. There's a lot of content in Sea Lion, and they're big and quite tough missions. So really designed for people that have that really into Panzer Corps and like the system. Right, we're going to jump our infantry ashore now. Our pioneers, that's engineers, more engineers, artillery. That's our heavy infantry coming up behind, and our anti-aircraft gun. Okay, so we've started to land. Our paratroopers are going to drop. They actually landed on target, but that uses up their turn, so we can't attack anyone this turn. Our fighter will continue to and weaken the hut. Oh, we did nothing. Just move him out of the way and bring in some. Oh, we have a target. We just found a 25-pound. Sorry, yeah, 25-pounder. They are quite mean artillery units, and so we're going to start picking on him. Two damage. Our fighter will continue to nibble at this airfield, no real
Ugh.
damage. And our JU-88, not sure what we want to do with him. We may just keep him out of the way for now. We don't want to get shot at by the anti-aircraft gun yet. And our boat will just do a bit more scouting to see what we can see up here. Oops, where have we found? A cargo ship. Well, because we bumped into him and he was in the shroud, technically that should be an ambush. It should be quite bad for us. In an ambush, the enemy gets to attack you with increased combat odds. But because the cargo ship has no weapons, the ambush didn't do anything to us, but it has ended our turn. So not too bad, but we just lose our attack. Nothing too scary up here, a bit more infantry, but nothing we can't handle. Okay, so moving across to the other main island. We're going to start using our little boats to scout around the edge to see if we can see anything. No sign of enemy ships, which is good. And we're just trying to try and get on shore as quick as we can. I think we want the infantry on land, our scout car on land, and artillery will just move to a deployment place for next turn. Right, so next turn we should have everyone disembarked. Our paratroopers, the suppression is gone now. They are up to full strength, so 10 out of 10. I don't know if you noticed, but their number was yellow. It's now back up to white to show their full strength. So we are going to try and take this airfield.
So how much does terrain impact the combat values?
Yeah, terrain's very important. Infantry in the open are pretty vulnerable to armoured units, but in towns or bocage or forest, it's a completely different story. So making use of terrain is critical to success, really, in lands of war. So we've destroyed the hangar, so now we can get in there and capture that next turn.
Right, because the airfield you have to capture with ground troops, I suppose.
Yeah, so the little flag shows the current ownership, currently British owned. Once we capture that, that'll turn to German controlled, and then we can start to use that as a place to refuel and rearm our aircraft. So we're just going to pull back from here for now. Because if we sit around here, we're going to get shot at with this anti-aircraft gun. So yeah, our main focus is get the troops ashore, and then our key objective, we've got two here and here. We maybe should have landed over this side actually, but anyway, a bit late for that now, because we've got to get all the way over here, but we do have 12 turns, so it shouldn't be too bad. We're going to come around, capture this one first, and then move on to here. The other areas here are not vital for our victory, so don't really need them. And then up to our little island. We're going to continue to bomb the artillery, so that's weakened them a bit. And we're going to hit this ship here before it does anything nasty to us. That's four damage on that, that's down to
Not
one
bad.
strength now, so that's really not much of a threat. Now, we didn't very cleverly position our ships because I've positioned them both in with only one landing zone to disembark, so there's nowhere for him to go this turn. I think I'll move him around to here so that he can disembark over here next turn. I think we have plenty of fuel at the moment, so there's no danger there. We'll continue to take this artillery down, and once that's gone, we can bring our infantry down here more safely. I think that's everything for this turn. Let's see what the enemy's got. Right, the AI artillery has started bombarding us. Suppress some of our infantry.
Ooh, more traps.
More trucks. What does that mean? Let's go have a look at those trucks. So we got bombarded here, but at the end of the turn, our suppression is recovered, and so we're back to full strength. So he didn't damage us, which is good. He just suppressed some of our infantry. So suppression would have been useful for him if he was then planning an attack against me.
Right.
So the way you use artillery is you do the artillery first, suppress the enemy, and then go in with ground attacks to really make the most of it. So we're going to ignore those trucks for now because I don't think Tomato trucks are much of a threat. And we're going to try and take this airfield. We've destroyed the hangar. And now we have captured the airfield. There we
Nice.
go. So now we have a safe base for our aircraft to land, refuel, and rearm. So that's good news. The next thing we want to do is take out this artillery. So we're going to focus our attacks. What else have we got? We've got some two fighters we can hit him with, or the two bombers. I'm going to hit him with a bomber. Complete miss. Bombers are better at suppressing than damaging. Whereas, so strategic bombers are good at suppression, whereas tactical bombers do are much better at damage and do much less suppression. So depending on what it is you're trying to achieve, you pick the best unit for that. So our pioneers have moved into the town. They're well equipped, they're experienced, they're over strength as well. So these guys, my guys, are at 11 strength. Once your units gain experience, you can do something called overstrengthening them, where you can push them above 10 strength points. It's quite expensive, but it makes them quite effective in combat. I'm more interested in getting rid of his air defenses right now, so I'm going to focus on the engineers. So that was pretty good. Nearly took them out, and only took, well, I didn't take any damage at all.
That's
And I'm going to bring my other engineers up into striking distance of the artillery for next turn.
so did I just notice that your engineers, your artillery actually also came with half tracks?
Yep, I didn't realize that actually. That's quite handy. So we just moved our artillery in half tracks. So if we just undo that move, let's just get them off the half tracks to show that. So unmounted, I can move one tile. So that's the range I can move and still shoot with them. As soon as I get onto transports, they can no longer shoot. But obviously, I can travel much further on transport. If I get caught on transport and attacked, then I'm pretty vulnerable. So you only really use transports when you're pretty safe. So here, actually, that's not a good plan. That's far too close to these guys. We'll bring them up to here. There we're relatively safe. And it puts us in striking distance to give some artillery support next turn. It would be risky if the enemy had any air power, because air units are very good at hitting units on board transport. But so far, we haven't seen any, so we're going to take a risk.
That's
So we just unloaded our 88mm anti-aircraft guns and our heavy infantry. So building up a nice force here. This looks relatively under control. We have some fighters here, and we will just start taking these trucks. I'm not sure if we need to do this or not, but might as well shoot some trucks. And we will start attacking this cargo ship.
taking revenge on his choice ambush.
It's painless ambush. So nothing else discovered up here. Coming across to the main island. Right, our paratroopers can capture the airfield, but I don't think we need them to. I think we're going to push our paratroopers forwards and let the next wave take the airfield. So
Oh, wow.
here we have a recon unit, and these guys move very fast. They can see far, but they also have a special option. So with recon units, you can move the partial move, and they've captured this location here. And then I can continue to move them on. Other units have to end their move. Have to move everything in one go.
Right.
So there, I had the chance to move him. He's captured two victory locations, and it just gives you a nice way of pushing your battle line forwards. I'm not going to get on board truck here because I just don't know what's in the shroud here. If I mount up on truck, I could easily be ripped to pieces, so we're going to stay disembarked.
So what's the difference between the trucks and the half tracks?
Trucks are very fast on road, but they're not brilliant at cross-country travel, and they offer less protection. Half tracks are still vulnerable when you're loaded, but a lot less vulnerable than when you're on a truck. So half tracks are generally just better. It's just a more expensive option. So you're always with Panzer Corps, your core force travels with you, and you're spending your points, and you're always looking for kind of the most efficient way to repair and achieve tasks. So we're just going to scout up here, see if there's anyone in that town. I could move my paratrooper straight into it and capture it, but there's a fair chance there's enemy units there.
So that would be, I mean,
That
you would
would be a
be
nasty
ambushed.
ambush, yeah.
Yep.
So we're just going to scout there. There's nothing there except an artillery piece. Oh, sorry, there's someone underneath me. We have found a Vickers Mark VI. So it's not a particularly effective tank, but it is still a tank. So fortunately, we flew straight in over it, so we can give it a little bit of. But I was tempted to move my paratroopers up here, but then I remembered my objective is nowhere up there. My objective is over here. So anything that takes me off in that direction is just a distraction. So we should really be pushing in this direction with our paratroopers. There is an advantage to capturing these things in some ways because it gives you some additional prestige.
Okay.
So it gives you more points to repair damage, but I'm not too concerned about that right now. We're more interested in. Pushing towards our objectives.
You mentioned that you take your core force from mission to missions. Do your troops also get like experience?
Yes, they do. So every time the guys fight, you can see on the sidebar here the experience building up. So these guys have 300 experience. I didn't actually import my core force here. So when I started Sea Lion, if I'd played the 1940 Grand Campaign, I could have brought my 1940 core force with me into this. But I've just used the default force that was in here.
Right.
And it starts with some experience already. So these guys have got 300 experience. So they get 3 stars, and that gives them various bonuses to do with initiative. Initiative's very important because it decides which strength points fire first. And that determines who gets to fire back. So if you fire first, you do some damage to the enemy. Only the undamaged strength points get to fire back. So it's a very important part, especially of air combat. Initiative in air combat is critical. I'm going to leave my aircraft around the air base because that just gives them a chance to refuel. My Messerschmitt still has 29 fuel out of 41, which is a fair bit. It's enough for a few turns, but there's no real targets for him. So I'm just going to let
So,
them.
in order to refuel, you have to keep them near the airfield for a full
Yes,
turn.
if they end their turn next to an air base or
Okay.
on top of an air base, they refuel. And the same with the Stuka. I'm just going to leave him there because I've got no real target to pick on. So we'll stay by the air base. Coming up to the little island at the top. We're going to try and finish off this little ship before it does anything annoying. There we go, that's him gone. And we're slowly working our way through this artillery. He's down to 7 strength. Right, we were going to land. And we're going to move and okay, so our infantry has landed. Next turn, we should be able to launch an assault and hopefully take this out, the artillery. And then we can come back for the supply base later. I'm not sure if there's an advantage to capturing that or not, but we'll do it just in case. So that's everyone move turn 3. Oh, turn 4, AI, some kind of scout car assaulted our pioneers. That's done a fair bit of damage. Those tanks have come down. But our paratroopers have given them a bloody nose.
Nice.
Okay, let's see what happens. So we had some kind of scout car come at us. What is this? A Rolls-Royce. So you can right-click on anything to find a bit of information about it. So tells us he's at 8 strength. All his stats are reported here. So soft attack 3, it's not particularly high. Hard attacks 3, not very high. It's not a particularly good unit. So I don't think it's too much of a threat. But it is still an armored unit, which means that it's a little bit of a challenge for our pioneers. We'd like to hit him with an air attack, but he's got an anti-aircraft gun next to him.
Yep.
And what we're going to do is send our pioneers in here to try and take out the anti-aircraft gun. There we go. That's dead. And now that means we can airstrike him with pretty much immunity.
Still two. We also got your artillery.
Yeah, we can hit him with artillery or we could hit the infantry. The other thing we can do is our anti-aircraft gun, the 88mm was a specially designed so that it could lower its sights and fire at ground targets. And so what we're going to do, we haven't seen an enemy aircraft anywhere, so we're going to switch him into ground attack mode.
Right.
He's can't move far enough to get anywhere useful this turn, but we'll creep him forwards. And next turn, if he's in range, he can probably take those out in one shot. What we will do though is our engineers will creep forwards to capture the town. Our other engineers are going to come into the town. And our heavy infantry come up here. So the heavy infantry are slightly better off against the scout car.
How about the supply word for the infantry units? We looked at the aircraft briefly, but they're need to refuel. Is there the same thing for infantry and
Infantry,
tanks?
yeah, infantry don't have any fuel, but they do have ammunition. So, actually, they do have fuel, but they use up fuel at such a low rate that they can go for 82 turns without being
Right, yeah.
refueled. So it's pretty meaningless for infantry, unless you're doing some enormous mega scenario. Ammunition, they get 5 rounds of ammunition. He's just used one by launching that attack, so he's got 4 more rounds of ammunition until he has to rearm. And units that run out of ammo do become extremely vulnerable because they cannot attack at all. And so if you can catch a unit without ammo and attack it, you get free attacks against it. So making sure you don't run out of ammo is an important part of
And how do you resupply that?
so resupplying. If I haven't moved, I can resupply, but I've already moved these guys, so
Okay.
they can't resupply this turn.
So you basically have to sacrifice a turn in
It
order
takes a
to.
turn to resupply. So
Okay.
this unit here hasn't yet moved or attacked, so he could resupply if he wanted to. Oh, sorry, the fuel, I'm talking rubbish about the fuel. The infantry don't have fuel. It's only because they've got transports.
Right.
It's
Okay.
the transports that are refueling there. So normally infantry without embedded transports, like I think these guys up here don't have embedded transports. So, they still actually do have a fuel counter, but it doesn't get used up at all, really. Okay, so our artillery, we're going to start attacking these guys. Another important concept in Panzer Corps is entrenchment. So these guys have an entrenchment level of 5. Every time they come under attack, their entrenchment level is reduced. And the entrenchment gives them big combat bonuses. So although this attack here isn't going to actually do any physical damage to them, it might do some suppression, and it will reduce their entrenchment level. So we can see we suppressed 3 strength points, and we reduced the entrenchment level to 4. So no actual damage, but if I do an attack against these guys now, my odds are much better. So I'm not going to attack them yet this turn. I'm going to wait one more turn to let them soften up a little bit more. And then we're going to move in to kill them. Going to hit them with airstrikes as well.
Nice. And these lower the entrenchment levels as well.
Yep, so that's the entrenchment level reduced again. This artillery unit here. And our paratroopers are now going to start moving forwards. Our fighter now is safe to come over here and attack the enemy armored cars. Discovered another supply base here. We'll just continue to advance. Have a look what's around the corner. See if there's enemy. Nothing too much there. So far the island is not looking too tough. It's the first scenario in the Sea Lion campaign, so it was supposed to ease you in gently. Probably a good thing for the length of time since I played a Panzer Corps scenario. Right, so next let's move east to take on this town. I'm going to hit the Stukas are actually very good ground attack, so this Stuka is probably going to make mincemeat of that town. Dead. Paratroopers can move across here safely. Our infantry is going to stay embarked and out range of this artillery. 1, 2, 3. And the rest of our units can jump on their trucks and try and catch up. Oh, bridge pioneers. Very useful on an island with no bridges. No rivers even. Right, and our recon. Okay, these guys, I think we're just going to shoot them right into the middle here to start getting a picture of what we're up against. So you can see the sighting range of these three. It
Yeah.
really does make a big difference to what you can see. So we discovered anti-aircraft gun, we can see again, enemy infantry, artillery. So I think our first priority is going to be to. Oh, it's tricky actually. We've got to get rid of the anti-aircraft, but the artillery is going to be a pain as well. So we might try and kill the artillery. The artillery is going to start hitting our infantry next turn. We've got a bit close there. Think we just have to get mass our force and try and hit them all at once. Bring our aircraft up next turn as well. So not going to do too much this turn. Just keep patrolling the island, see if there's any more ships. Doesn't look like there's anything too dangerous.
Yeah, so this is where you actually really miss the fact that you don't have any armor available.
Yes, armor would be ideal for coming in here to take them on. The recon unit's not bad at it actually, so we'll probably send our recon unit forward next turn to launch the attack there and then bring up some infantry to support them.
Oh, there was a question on these non-landing zones we see here in the small island.
Right, yeah, these are shallow water and your landing craft can't move into them. So it gives a way of creating scenarios where there's limited landing points. And so I was forced to either land at this end of the island or in disembark in range of the artillery.
Yep.
And so I decided I wanted to disembark up here to give my aircraft some time to start
Nice.
whittling away at this artillery. And hit them with two artillery attacks this turn. And then, oops, bring the infantry forwards and hopefully hit the artillery as well. So next we can start working on the infantry in the town. But that's this turn done. So we're four turns in. So far looks under control. Yeah, came a bit far forwards, but only one damage, that's not too painful. Oh, discovered another naval gun. Sorry, coastal gun. Where was that coastal gun? That was up here. I don't think there's any point in really going any further. Come back this way. I walked into another ambush.
You're running out of ammo.
Yeah, so that little warning symbol that's come up there means these guys are now down to one round of ammunition. They only start with two, so they only yeah, they don't have a lot of shots, but yes, he is now low on ammo. Right, so
And ships, can they resupply anywhere, or do they have to?
ships need to come to ports to
Right,
resupply,
okay.
but I don't have any friendly ports right now, so we'll need to capture one of these and get them into it. First thing I want to do is get rid of this artillery that is still hitting with the fighter, and then the paratrooper. Don't do that. Steady progress there. These guys are partially repaired, but repaired strength points are suppressed, so you have to take turn for your repair to kind of take effect. I think we can kill him before he really gets. Oh, take effect. One of the other things is after you do a ground attack, suppress strength points recover, so you get a chance to attack them whilst they're disorganized, but the attack effectively forces them to sort their act out. So now that's actually a stronger unit than before I attacked it, which is a bit unfortunate. Right. Bombard these guys again. Airstrike them again. We'll airstrike that armored car. That was completely ineffective.
The
Well, we have suppressed them though, so
right,
now the
yeah.
attack is down to a 5-0 in our favour, so may not have done much damage, but it did enough to reduce the entrenchment level and suppress them. So, first major objective captured. Let's finish off these annoying little cars. No, these do not want to die. Push them back a bit, so we'll advance. Bring our anti-aircraft gun up. And our artillery. And that's about it for the first island. Over to the second one. Right.
So this is probably the most challenging island.
Yes, yeah, it looks like it. This town looks like the biggest problem we have. Right. Actually, our infantry.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, artillery are not very good on a direct attack. So. Not as good as predicted, but still pretty damaging. Paratroopers should be able to get in there and finish them.
So how accurate are these predictions? Like, how reliable are they?
Not entirely reliable. It's the way that this combat system works on rolling kind of a chance to hit for every strength point you've got. So 10 strength points means 10 attacks, and each one has a chance to hit, and then it calculates the predicted damage on that. So if you had a 50% chance to hit with 10 strength points, you'd get a predicted addition of 5 damage. It gets more complicated because initiative kicks in. So who shoots first?
Right.
The higher the initiative you have, the more of your strength points fire before the enemy strength points. So it gets into quite a complicated calculation about how much damage is inflicted. So they give an indicator, but you can't rely on them. And it's a war game, so you're not supposed to have completely accurate predictions. It's supposed to give you indicators, and then your plan has to deal with what happens when things don't go to plan effectively. So we've taken the artillery out. The next target is this anti-aircraft gun, so we can bring in our air support. So our recon unit can get an attack 4-1, so that seems like reasonable odds. So we did 4 damage and received none. So sometimes the predictions go better than expected. Right. Not sure we want to bring our infantry that close in trucks. Bring artillery forwards a bit. Guys off their trucks. Keep these guys off their trucks. Now we're getting a bit crowded. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Let's scout this area out a little bit. Check there's no enemy units around. Just a supply dump and some infantry, so nothing that's going to scare our anti-aircraft guns. So we can bring them forwards. Just a bit of scouting over here as well. No enemy forces there. Our Stuka's just going to wait for a target. Continue circling the island up here. I think there.
It seems like the defense is really focused around the.
It is. It's very much this town, so it's a relatively easy mission for the first start of the campaign. So on to our last little island. Let's finish off the supply dump. Destroyed.
So are there different difficulty levels in game?
There are challenge. About 7 difficulty levels, I think. Well, let me think. Is it 5 or 7? I forget now. There's at least 5, possibly 7, and there's also 3 bonus difficulty levels. So once you've completed the game on the hardest setting, it unlocks special difficulty settings. There's I think it's Rommel, Guderian, and I forget the names of the levels, but there's 3 levels that have special difficulties. Some of them mean you have to complete the game in less turns. Some give you reduced prestige, but they all give you different ways to play.
Right.
The base difficulty levels affect how many strength points your units have and how many strength points the enemy units have. So there really is a level for everybody. On the lowest setting, then it's really you can pick up and play. Anyone can pick up and play. On the hardest settings, I mean, I don't play on the hardest settings. I play in the middle setting, and that's enough of a challenge for me. I think that's us moved everybody. So we're just coming up to halfway through the campaign. Oof, that artillery unit just did nasty damage to us. 4 strength. So, got to capture here. I think we're just going to stay away from these naval guns because they just seem a bit mean. This thing is repaired back up to 7 strength points now. We need to try and finish him off. Now, I want to get my anti-tank guns next to him, but if I attack him with these, it's likely I'll force him to retreat. If you suppress all the strength points in an enemy unit with an attack, that will force them to retreat. And I'd have probably forced them to retreat out of range of my anti-tank gun. There we go. One shot from the 88s was all it took. Unfortunately, we found another artillery unit, which is in range of our engineers. So we want to try and do something to them. This tomato truck is beginning to annoy me. So I don't know if there's anything hidden on board or if they really are tomato trucks, so we're going to take them out just in case. And this one here
No one can argue against free tomatoes.
really. And we'll just airstrike some trucks, I guess. Tomatoes everywhere. Paratroopers, just stay out of range of that coastal gun. And there are so we have a port now, so we'll bring our ship back to port. I think that's that island done. Now the main event. Okay, so we want to. Oh, we don't need much help. This anti-aircraft gun isn't very charge in there. Our recon unit should be able to finish it off. And this coastal
Yeah, it
battery
is.
is a pain, but I don't actually need to kill it. It can't move. The garrison in there can't come out, can't do anything. So if I can kill the infantry here and capture the main victory location, I don't actually need to take that on. We can just starve them out later. So I think we will focus on suppressing those guys. Can now bring in our air. Oh, excellent. Don't need to move you.
That's why there is the undo button.
Yes, always useful. Stuka, let's bring you in and start hammering these guys. So we've dropped their entrenchment level by 3 and done some damage to them. So I think next turn we should be able to take them on. We didn't take any damage, luckily, but that was a bit careless.
So, how do you know which of these troops you're moving about are part of your core force? So, which one you should.
So the core force units have gold borders around them, and the
Okay.
auxiliary units have grey borders. So you can see the difference between my fighter here and my
Yeah.
boat. So that unit's going to carry over with me to the next mission, whereas the little attack boat isn't.
So for the attack bot, you wouldn't care as much if you gain experience or.
No, you tend to look after your core force much more than your auxiliary units. Often there are objectives inside the mission to look after auxiliary units as well. So you might have a mission to try and look after them or make sure a certain number survive. But if you don't, then sometimes the auxiliary units are thrown into the fight first to just to make sure you save your favourite units. Right, over to our little island up here. It's time to start bombing these guys.
Actually running out of ammo.
We are. But we just captured the airfield. So we need to capture the airfield. Oops. The tail, so that island is secure. We just need to move our aircraft back to base there to refuel.
Yep.
Other than that, that island's sorted. So halfway through, one of the three objectives completed, and this one doesn't look too tricky, so I think everything's on track, which is surprising. Never usually goes to plan. Okay, so before we forget, we're just going to move our air unit back. So here we can see it's got a fuel warning. He's only got 9 out of 53 fuel. So this was just in time, actually. An ammo warning, he's got 0 ammo left. So that was all. I didn't realise how close we were. Yeah, another couple of turns and our aircraft would have been in trouble.
Did you deal with the supply dump yet? That was at the top of the
Yeah,
island?
We blew that up at the start, I think. Yeah, cleared that. That's all gone. I'm not sure if there's anyone on that island, but we don't care. Okay. So back to our tomato trucks. Let's blow up. Right, so now we can see a slightly different situation. So the red dots show where, if I move to these areas, I will not have enough fuel to get back home. So this unit has currently 16 fuel. If I move out here, I'll use up so much fuel I cannot get back to the airbase. So this is now very important. I do not want to hit anything outside of the white zone. So I'll strike him, then fly back to refuel. This guy has more fuel, so he's safe. He can just fly up here and strike him.
Oh, nice.
So that's good. Our pioneers are in range to attack him, but we've only got one ammo point left. I don't see any major threat though, so I think we'll take the risk and try and look at it. Okay, took a bit of damage, but the artillery's gone. Now we are now down to 0 ammo, so they are very vulnerable. But I don't think there's anyone in a position to.
So at this point, when someone would attack them, they wouldn't fire back.
That's right. They are just sitting ducks now. No bullets left whatsoever. Try and kill this truck. So he's gone, that's heavy. That lets our engineers move more freely up here. Yep. I think though we'll just capture the port because it gives us some prestige points which are useful for repairing. Creep forwards. Don't want to end up on the truck. Right, we've got one aircraft left here to strike with. Oh, heavy infantry. Then we'll move up. Paratroopers, take out supply dump. And now everywhere, we're getting low on ammo everywhere. We're going to have to start thinking about rearming. So that can really play havoc with your turn counts. Need to make sure you allow enough time to reload. So I'm only one on, well, these guys are 2 moves away from the objective, plus they're going to have to spend a turn rearming, 3 turns. So we've still got time to get there, but it is starting to get close. Right, over this side. We need to be careful we don't get too sucked in here. We're going to have to start sending forces straight across to this area here. Our artillery. Infantry unit. Right, that's pretty heavily damaged. Our heavy weapons infantry will come in now and see. Destroy it. There we go.
Nice.
All we need to do is occupy it. So we've occupied the objective. But I got too tempted. Right then.
Can the boats occupy that victory location since it's harbor
I forget, to be honest.
port
Let's
hack.
see what happens. No, they
Okay.
can't occupy it. They can occupy, but they can't capture it.
Yeah.
Only certain unit types can capture, so things like artillery, I think anti-aircraft guns as well, they can't capture locations. So yeah, only certain unit types can actually capture. So we've only got one infantry unit over here, so it's nothing too much to worry about. We've captured the objective here. Just gonna scout what's up here. Nothing, so we might as well capture that. Gives us some points. So now everyone shoots across to take the last infantry location. Our artillery just want to get into bombardment range if they can. Not quite this turn. So who's left to move? Just these guys over here. So
They've done their job.
yeah. Ah, Stukas might as well start here. And our boats aren't really any use anymore. They can attack, but they'll just kill themselves, so we won't bother.
The boats run out of fuel, do they sink or? I mean, they have a
I
huge
think
fuel capacity,
I
so I don't
don't
think it would ever happen. But
I think that they I've never seen it happen actually. I think they would just end up not being able to move, because for a ship running out of fuel, it would just sit there until
right.
somebody rescued it, really. Whereas an aircraft runs out of fuel is a slightly different situation. If air units run out of fuel, they're basically destroyed. So there we go, turn 7 into turn 8, and it's all looking just about within grasp. So we need to rest you guys, resupply. We can actually heal if we, I can't remember if I heal if I get ammo as well. Let me try. Yes. So by doing reinforcements, I get resupplied in ammo with fuel as well. But it costs me prestige points to
Okay.
reinforce. So they're moving in here, so you should start the airstrikes. Slowly walk forwards. We'll refuel. These guys are now rearmed. Ships. It's our paratroopers in striking distance, and we've still got some tomato trucks to deal with. Save our aircraft for now. We'll end up getting them damaged otherwise, and we'll need them in the next mission. Okay, so let's continue with the airstrikes. Oh, the mission needs to return to base.
Yep.
This one can just about get limit of his range. He can do a strike in the next 30 minutes. Artillery can just get in range. And our infantry
Oh,
will.
yeah, they're all
We're going to try and
reasonably
reclaim quite a
fine.
bit of infantry here. Take a bit of damage, but
That's fine at this
we
point.
want to get an early victory.
So your damage also carries over to the next mission?
Yes, yeah, the damage carries over. You can repair in between missions, you get a kind of an army management phase where you get the chance to upgrade and all those kind of things. Because as you go through the war, new technologies become available.
All right, yeah.
We're just going to pull out of range of this annoying turret, because it can't do anything to us anymore.
Can your boat at the on the right-hand side hit the enemy infantry in the final
He
location?
can attack him, but he doesn't actually do anything.
All right.
I suppose it reduces the entrenchment. Every little helps. And the last island we've captured, so there's nothing to do there. Everybody's happy. So that's that. Boats are
Speaking of
it's
tomatoes
one of the
pooping
trucks have
about.
repaired themselves. I better go and finish
So,
them properly in case they mean something. I think we have enough resources up here to take this guy on, so continue with the airstrikes. Who is the best at ground suppression? Ground attack. So soft attack. He's got an A8. And this one has a 10. So our 88A is our best ground attack. Yeah, so we'll send him in. Didn't kill anything, but he did suppress 3 strength points, so that's pretty good. The artillery range. So they suppressed another 4 strength points and killed 2, so that's very good. Oh, our engineers can't reach. These ones can.
oh wow,
I got them.
you get them.
Very good. So on board the half tracks they can reach, so we capture the objective. So I think this island's done. We've captured the hangars. I'm just gonna check. We've missed a hangar over here. No, that's a fortress. We already know that's a fortress. So I think we've captured this island. It's just the
They are brave.
surround them. Right. So the only objective left to capture is Stukas. Still got fuel. Low on ammo now. Ship will help out. And then the infantry ship. So it's all about combined arms with Panzer Corps, using your artillery to suppress, air defences to protect versus airstrikes, and all those kind of combined arms. And I think
I
that
think that
should be the
was a
scenario end.
very successful execution of the first mission.
That was, I'm surprisingly good.
Yeah,
When we played Armageddon the other day, it did not go quite to plan like this. So I think we're done. Decisive victory. There we go. So, how long have we got left?
we're pretty much
Oh,
done
we're
for
out of
time,
time.
really.
Okay, well, we'll just quickly jump in to show how the core force concept works. So, we're into our that gave us a kind of an out of mission briefing, and then it's into next mission briefing what we've got to do. We're going to skip past that for now just to show how things work. So, this is the management screen between missions. So, as I was mentioning, there's new technologies become available. So the Panzer 3G is now available, a Nebelwerfer rocket launcher is available, and a Stug 3B. And I can either buy units of these types or I can upgrade existing units to these types. So if I jump into here, I'm looking at a Panzer 38T. These are the tanks that got captured from the Czech Republic when they got taken over. I can go for the upgrade options. And that Panzer 3G that we just saw is now an option for me to upgrade to. And on the upgrade screen, you can see very easily the difference between the different stats. So I currently have a Panzer 38TA, I think. Is it that one? Must be. Yeah. So upgrading to 3F, that's the cost. So the red means the number's higher, so it would be a cost to do. It has less fuel, has more ammo, better hard attack values, better hard defense and air defense. So generally, it's a the 3F's a slightly better tank. The 3G, much improved ammo, improved ground defense, much better hard attack, another iteration up, so a further improvement. And the 4D is a slightly different type of tank. So good soft. So it's an anti-infantry tank. It's got a short barrel. So all the units have their own different specialties and abilities.
And that list of units will fill up as you.
As you go, yeah, later in the war, you'll have masses of options on ways to upgrade. And you actually have some captured units in my force here as well. So in the fall of France. I must have captured a char B, which I can't buy, and that has its own kind of set special abilities. Later in the war, it will become a bit obsolete, but at this stage, it's still quite a powerful unit. And this unit here has a different camouflage pattern. This means it's a special elite unit. These units are granted as a reward for, I can't remember how you get them exactly now, if it's for decisive victories or just generally as you go through the campaign, you'll be awarded elite units, and they have special stats. They're generally higher attack and lower defense than the same unit, so they're good strike units for penetrating tough positions. So here we see my core force is quite substantial. I've got two strategic bombers, four tactical bombers, four Messerschmitts, couple of air defense units, five artillery units already, only one scout unit, quite a few tanks, and quite a few infantry. So that's quite a substantial force. And what we're looking at here is actual, this is Sea Lion. So that
This
was
is.
the previous mission was a prelude. And this is the first kind of major mission. It's going to be much more of a challenge than the previous one. I actually have to get my troops across, embark them, get them across, and get them out the other side. I'll have the Royal Navy and the Royal Air Force to oppose me this
Yeah,
time.
I expect you have a lot more. I mean, Britain wasn't
It's
defending its islands with any.
no, that was more of a tutorial than anything, the previous mission. This is going to be a lot tougher. So I do have much more naval forces at my disposal, submarines, battle cruisers, cruisers. So I've got a fairly potent navy myself, but I'm going to have some major opposing force. And I have some more auxiliary units here as well. So yeah, this is a big scenario. This is where the game really starts to get a lot more interesting. But that's all we've got time for today. So Sea Lion released today. Oh, so Lines of Hexes. I didn't read my briefing, but I assume the Line of Hexes is something to do with where we've searched for mines, or it could be something to do with where the enemy naval units are. So I may have to keep my forces in this area or run the risk of more naval or air attacks. So the mission briefing, if once you read it, it'll tell you exactly what that's for. But I skipped through that. So yeah, Panzer Corps Sea Lion is out today. It's available on Steam. It's available on our site. It's available on iOS. So the iPad version has this in, and the update's out there. And Panzer Corps is also on sale. 50% off for today on PC and iOS. The packages for Panzer Corps Complete and the Grand Campaign are on sale as well. They're 30% off, although we just had to wait for Steam to trigger the packages. So whether that's live or not yet, I'm not entirely sure, but should be later today. If not, we'll make sure that goes up as soon as possible.
And just to make sure, Operation Sea Lion requires ownership of Panzer Corps.
It is an expansion. Yes, it requires the base game. Well, that's all, guys. Thanks very much. And do we know what the next week we're twitching?
I don't think we know yet, actually.
I can't remember what's the release next week. I can't remember. Do we know? I forget.
We got the Northern Inferno releasing next
Northern
week.
Inferno releases next week, so it must be Northern Inferno Twitch, is it, next Thursday? Is that what we're doing?
Well, we
Could
could
be.
try. We'll try and
No?
grab
Okay.
it.
We'll find out. We'll find out what it is, but there will be a Twitch next Thursday.
All right. Thank you very much for watching, guys, and hopefully we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.